सो हेलो एवरीवन, आई होप आई एम ऑडिबल एंड विजिबल. प्लीज गिव मी अ क्विक थम्स अप इफ माय ऑडियो वीडियो इज क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू एंड देर इज नो इशू विद द कनेक्शन. सो वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑफ लेट्स क्रैक नीट पीजी एंड आई एम डॉक्टर चेष्टा अग्रवाल, योर नीट पीजी एजुकेटर ऑन एन अकेडमी. टुडे वी विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग विद द पार्ट ऑफ एनाटमी. वी वर डूइंग द न्यूरो एनाटमी. वी स्टार्टेड विद द डिस्कशन ऑफ द बोन्स, दैट इज ऑस्टियोलॉजी. And then we have went ahead and we have discussed little bit about the different parts of the brain, the dural venous sinuses, the layers and all. Now today we will be continuing, or we will be taking our discussion ahead from there, and we will discuss about the main lobes or main part of the brains. For example, cerebrum, then followed by cerebellum, or we will discuss first the cerebrum and then the thalamus part, then pons, cerebellum and the medulla. That will be our sequence. Okay, so I request all of you to please join the class fast. Before starting the today's session, let me introduce an offer going on currently on the platform, and that is the 3+1 subscription of an academy. If you take a 3-month subscription of an academy using the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT, so if you subscribe to an academy using the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT, you will get an additional 1 month absolutely free. So I request all my dear students to please hurry and get this offer, because this is a very limited time period offer. Now my students who are currently in their MBBS, whether first, second, third or final year MBBS, or those students who are eligible for next pattern examination, that is from 2022 onwards, I will request all of you to join iconic subscription of an academy. Iconic means they will give you an access of an academy as well as prep ladder, the two best online platforms of our country. Now why I'm saying you to join this, because currently we are going on with an amazing discount on this iconic subscription, that if you use the referral code Dr. Cheshta, that is my name, and YT stands for YouTube, if you use this referral code, you will get the 92,000 rupees of 3 years subscription in 58,000 rupees only. Similarly, 77,000 of 2 years will reduce to 49,000, 66 of 1.5 year will reduce to 45, 55 of 12 months will reduce to 40 years. So you have amazing discounts going on currently on the platform. You just need to take the subscription using the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT. On the platform Unacademy learning app, you have 34,000 questions which are specially curated for your PPG preparation. What do you do? You just have to download the Unacademy learning app, unlock the questions using the referral code. These are free questions. You just need to unlock them. Use either Dr. Cheshta YT or Cheshta 10 to unlock these questions, which is present absolutely free of cost on the platform. We are also conducting a first year MBBS batch course right now, which is a plus course. You need to take a subscription for attending the class of this. Here we will be discussing the anatomy, physiology and biochemistry in detail, which will help you understand the subjects in detail, create a foundation for your entrance examination, as well as will improve your university marks. So please, my first year students, subscribe to an academy, and you know that how to subscribe. Download the app, use the code Dr. Cheshta YT. Okay. For those who will be giving their exam this year, that is my final year students or the post-final intern students, please subscribe to an academy and join the batch courses which is going on. Currently, these are the 3 batch courses which have started on 12th of the May. So please be a part of it. Now, good evening all of you and welcome to this session. Now, what we have already covered, just revising it a little bit, what we have already covered. Now, one thing we know from the yesterday's session, that okay, so we have discussed here that a brain which is developed from the neural cord or the neural tube, it has many parts in them. I hope this is clear to all of you. So please remember, brain which develops from the neural tube, it has many parts. The cranial part of the neural tube, the cranial part of the neural tube will form a bulge to form the future brain, and the caudal part remains in a tube-like pattern to form the future spinal cord. I think this everybody knows. The cranial bulge will further divide into three bulges. The topmost is called as prosencephalon, the middle one is the mesencephalon, and the lower part is the rhombencephalon. The prosencephalon further divide into two parts. The outermost is telencephalon and the second one is diencephalon. Now please remember, the telencephalon is two in number, that is one pair, and they will form future cerebra. Please remember, cerebrum is a very, very important part, or you can call it as the functional part of the human brain. I'm not saying that other part is not functional, but the major part, the cognition, the understanding, all this part, emotions, emotion is not that related to the cerebrum, but the functional capability, the intelligence, everything depends upon the cerebral cortex. Is that clear to all of you? Now just imagine, now look at this part. This we are looking at the brain from the top, and we have another part, this one. Here we are looking cerebrum from the side. This is the side view. Now what do you mean by side view is that there are two telencephalon bulges like this, which will later form the mature cerebrum like this. Please give me a thumbs up, all of you, if you understood the two swellings, or that is the two bulge which were telencephalon, the cranial most part of the neural tube will later develop to forms cerebrum, which has multiple dip and multiple raised structures. Now these depressions are called as sulcus, and the raised part is called as gyrus. Understood, all of you? The depressed part is called as sulcus and the raised part is called as gyrus. So in between two gyrus, we have one sulcus. And in this manner, there is a large surface area of brain which is present in a small cranial cavity. I hope this is clear to all of you, Yash, Riya, and all the other students. We have 14 students right now live with us. Okay? Chalo. Now, there are many gyri and many sulci which you need to know. But before that, please remember, broadly, there are four main lobes of the cerebrum. What are these lobes? Look at this image. The anterior most part, this is the anterior part. I'll use a red color pen, I think you'll understand better. The anterior most part is called as the frontal lobe. The posterior most part is called as occipital lobe. The little on the side, it is the parietal lobes, the upper sides, and little on the lower sides, we have temporal lobe. Understood, all of you? Please give me a quick thumbs up if you understood. So you have in total four lobes: frontal lobes, occipital lobe, parietal lobe, and temporal lobe. Now I have just now told you that cerebrum is mainly doing the intellectual function of the body. The intelligence or the mature functions of the body is conducted through the cerebrum. Thank you, Srishti. I will be definitely continuing these series, so don't worry. I will try to complete the whole anatomy before your NEET PG entrance examination. Now, if you ask me what is the broad, or what you say that mota mota, what is the function of the frontal lobe? So please remember, the frontal lobe, the major function is to do the intellectual function. Okay? What is the major role of the temporal lobe? It helps in the assessment of the hearing. The parietal lobe, this is useful for the sensory function. And occipital lobe is useful for the visual function. Please give me a quick thumbs up if you understood all this. This I am talking broadly. I am not telling anything in detail. Broad, if I tell you, occipital lobe is dealing with the vision. Parietal lobe is dealing with the sensation. Frontal lobe is dealing with the motor function but with an intellectual action. And temporal lobe is broadly dealing with the action of hearing. Now there are many lobes or many gyri and sulci which you need to learn. Please remember these gyri and sulci are important for your entrance examination. Now look at this. This diagram looks very complicated, and that is why I will make a very easy diagram for all of you to remember. So we will make a diagram by ourselves, somewhat like this. Okay, so imagine this to be a simplified version of this image. Now there are few sulci and gyri which you all should remember. Okay, the first and the foremost is the central sulcus. Why it is called as central? Because it is present in the center part of the cerebrum. So this is called as the central sulcus. Now just remember, the part which is present in front of the central sulcus is called as precentral gyrus, and the part of the gyrus or part of the brain which is present just behind of the central sulcus is called as postcentral gyrus. Please give me a thumbs up if you understood. I think this is very easy. The part of the brain or the part of the gyri which is present just in front of the central sulcus, this is called as precentral gyrus, because I've told you the raised part is the gyrus and the depressed part is the sulcus, and the part which is present behind is the postcentral gyrus. This is a very important part because the postcentral gyrus is the primary, I'll use another color otherwise you'll get confused. I'll use a purple color. Can you tell me what is the role of postcentral gyrus? Anyone? What is the role of postcentral gyrus? It is considered to be the primary sensory area. And Broadbent have given this area few numbers, that is 3, 1 and 2. Please remember this. This is very easy. There is a central sulcus which is present in the center part of the brain. Okay. I'm talking about one half. We are cutting it like this. So this is the central sulcus. The part which is present behind is called as posterior part of the posterior central gyrus, which is dealing with the primary sensory area. And look at this. I think I have an image of this. Yes. So the part which is present behind is the primary sensory area, and the part which is present just in front of it, that is the precentral gyrus, is called as primary motor area. I request all of you to please give me a thumbs up if you understood primary motor area. And what is the name given to it, or what is the number given to this? The number given to it is 4 in the Broadbent's classification. This is a very important sulcus, that is the central sulcus. Now the sulcus which is present in front of the central sulcus here, it is called as precentral sulcus. The gyrus which is present before the central sulcus, it is called as precentral gyrus. But a sulcus which is present in front of the central sulcus is called as precentral sulcus. And can you tell me what is the part of the brain in front of precentral sulcus called as? Anyone? What is the part of the brain in front of pre-central sulcus called as here? I'm talking about this area. What is the role of the pre-central sulcus? The pre-central sulcus is this one, which is the association area. Clear? The pre-central sulcus, the number 6, is the association area. Okay? I hope this is clear to all of you. These are two important sulcus which you have to read in the center. Now we will discuss about this lobe. Can you tell me what is this lobe? This one. This is the temporal lobe. This is the temporal lobe. In temporal lobe, we have two main sulcus. Can you tell me what are those two main sulcus which is present in the temporal lobe? One is superior temporal sulcus. Why it is called as superior? Because it is present above the inferior one. Why it is called as temporal? Because it is present in the temporal lobe. And why it is called as sulcus? Because this is a depressed area. So in the temporal lobe, you have superior central sulcus and superior temporal sulcus and inferior temporal sulcus. Is that clear, all my dear students? Is that clear? And similar to this, you have two more sulcus in the frontal area, which is called as superior frontal sulcus and inferior frontal sulcus. I know it is a little boring, but please try to be with me for some more time. These are important because I've seen questions, they will just give you the part of the cerebrum. Acha, can you tell me what surface is this? I think I forgot to tell you about this. So please remember, this is the superolateral part, or this is the lateral part of the brain. For example, if I cut the scalp from here, for example, if I am taking a coronal sulcus, now please look at this image, this one. There are three parts of the cerebrum. What are those three parts? One is the inferior portion. One is the lateral portion. And another one is the medial portion. Please give me a quick thumbs up if you understood. This is the coronal sulcus. So you have a lateral part, you have an inferior part, and you have a medial part. Everybody give me a thumbs up if you understood what I'm trying to tell. So this image is, if we are looking it from this end, if we are looking this part of the brain, it will appear somewhat like this. Everybody give me a thumbs up if you understood that this is the lateral part of the cerebrum. All of you, Ria, Yash, Tina, we have around 20 students in my class. I want everybody to please give me a quick thumbs up because this is very important to understand the orientation. Okay, we are talking about the lateral aspect of the cerebrum. I will be teaching you the medial aspect also. There are few sulcus which is important to remember in the medial part as well. So you have the superior frontal sulcus, you have inferior frontal sulcus. Now I have told you the part which is present between the sulcus is the gyri. So this part is superior temporal gyrus, median temporal gyrus, and inferior temporal gyrus. Here it is superior frontal gyrus, middle frontal gyrus, and inferior frontal gyrus. Quickly give me a thumbs up if everybody have understood till here. All of you, Komal, Sumita, Riya, Yash, everyone give me a quick thumbs up if you have understood till here. Now look at this image. Look at this image. Now this, what is this cut? What is this part which I have drawn? This part. This is also a sulcus which divides the frontal lobe from the temporal lobe, and this is present on the lateral surface of the cerebrum, and that is why it is called as lateral sulcus. Clear all of you? So I think I should write it somewhere else. I'll write it at the top so that we have space for writing. So this becomes the lateral sulcus. Just at the margin where the lateral sulcus end, you have something called as angular sulcus. Look at this. You have an angular sulcus like this, and the area which is present above and below is called as angular gyrus. Okay? So here you have an angular sulcus, and this area is called as angular gyrus. Please give me a thumbs up if this is clear. And in the end, you have one sulcus which is going like this, and the area which is present, this is the auditory area. Can you tell me what is the auditory area? Anyone? Which is the auditory area in the occipital lobe? It is the number 17, 18 and 19. These are 17 is the primary auditory area. Primary auditory area. While 18 and 19 is the association areas. I hope this is clear to all of you. So little bit about the sulci, little bit about the gyri, which is present over the lateral margin or lateral surface of the cerebrum. Now look at the median surface. Median means I want everybody to look at this part. This is the median surface. So we are looking at this part till now. And now I am going and showing you the medial aspect of the cerebrum. So all of you, please look at the median part of the cerebrum. In the median part, can you tell me what is this white color structure? I will tell you after some time. There is the fibers, the commissural fibers, which connect the two lobes of the cerebrum. These commissural fibers which are present and connecting the two lobes and presenting in the center, it is called as corpus callosum. Okay, don't worry about that. I'll tell you in some time what is corpus callosum, what is commissural fibers, projection fibers, association fiber. Don't worry about that. But for now, you just need to look for few sulcus. Now, we have already read about this central sulcus. Now, can you tell me what is this sulcus? This sulcus is called as cingulus sulcus. And the gyri which is present surrounding it is called as cingulate gyrus. Very important. When I will be teaching you the limbic system, I will tell you that cingulate gyrus is a part and a very important structure of the limbic system. The anterior margin, can you see this part is going like this? And in the anterior margin, you have two vertical slit. These are the paraolfactory gyrus. At the back, you can see that corpus callosum. What is this part of the corpus callosum? Anyone? This is the isthmus. And this is the, what is this? This is the collateral sulcus and the occipitotemporal sulcus. On the median aspect of the temporal lobe, you have upper one which is called as collateral sulcus and the lower one is called as occipitotemporal sulcus. And the gyri which is present just above the collateral sulcus is called as parahippocampal gyrus. So please remember the cingulate gyrus, the parahippocampal gyrus and the isthmus part all together forms the component of the limbic system. Okay? Please give me a quick thumbs up if you understood. You don't have to know all the thing. Just remember about the cingulate gyrus, cingulate sulcus, paraolfactory gyrus. Then please remember uncus and remember the parahippocampal gyrus. If you are not understanding, don't worry. I will be telling you everything in detail when we will be reading the diencephalon or the midbrain structures. Okay? Abhishek is asking, ma'am, where we can get such amazing PDFs to download. So Abhishek, please download the Unacademy Learning app. Subscribe to Unacademy using the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT and download as much as PDFs you need to download. ठीक है अभिषेक, अंडरस्टूड. सो यू कैन डाउनलोड दिस, एवरीथिंग इज प्रेजेंट, बट यू हैव टू गेट द सब्सक्रिप्शन फॉर दिस. एंड फॉर गेटिंग द सब्सक्रिप्शन यू नीड टू यूज द कोड डॉक्टर चेष्टा YT. ठीक है, सो आई थिंक वी आर डन विद ऑल दी सल्काय एंड गायराय, एंड वी हैव डिस्कस लिटिल बिट अबाउट द ब्रॉडमेन्स एरियाज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वॉट इज द ब्रॉडमेन एरिया फॉर एनी वन विच इज प्रेजेंट जस्ट इन फ्रंट ऑफ द सेंट्रल सर्कस? इट इज द प्राइमरी मोटर एरिया. The part which is present just behind the central sulcus is the primary central sensory area. Now number 5 and 7 is called as somatosensory area. Somatosensory area. Okay. Can you tell me what is number 45 and 44? It is the Broca's speech area. And Broca's is the motor speech area. Then here, can you see? This was the angulate gyrus. 41, 40 was angulate gyrus. I hope you remember this image. So, not this image. Yeah, this part. I'm talking about this part. Angulate gyrus is 41 and 42 is the Wernicke's speech area, which is the sensory speech area. Remember or not, all of you? I hope you all have read this. Now, what is 21? It is the auditory area. It is the auditory area. And 52, 22, 42 is the association areas. Auditory association areas. Understood or not? So this much you are required to know. 17 is the primary auditory area and 19 and 18 is the association area. If you know this much also, trust me, you can solve 80% of the questions from this particular topic. If you know even this much of the Brodmann's area, you can do a lot of questions yourself. Clear, all of you? Please give me a thumbs up if you understood. And this is another image where I've shown a lot of areas. The somatosensory areas is the 5-7. The visual association area is 19-18. Primary visual area is number 17. Then we have Wernicke's area is 41-42 and 22. Then primary auditory area is 41-42. Then we have Broca's area, which is 45 here. Okay, then we have the motor area, which is 4, and the premotor areas, which is the association fibers. I hope everybody is clear till here. Now, if you cut the brain like this, just look at this. I'm cutting the brain in the coronal section. You can see that there are gray color structures present on the outer part, and the white color structure is present in the inner mass. The gray color structure is called as gray matter, and the white color structure is called as white matter. Please give me a quick thumbs up if you understood. The gray color structure is called as gray matter, and the white color central part is called as white matter. But what is this gray and what is this white? Anybody can tell me what is this gray and what is this white? What is the brain made up of? What is the basic component of the brain? Or what is the cell of the brain, or the smallest structure of the brain? Please remember, the smallest structure of our brain is a neuron. How does neuron look like? It is somewhat like this. You have a nucleus. From the nucleus, you have multiple dendrites. One dendrite get long and it forms the axon. This axon is covered by a sheath which is called as myelin sheath, and this myelin sheath is white in color. So please remember, all my dear students, the gray part of the cerebrum or the gray part of the brain, it is made up of nucleus. It is made up of the nucleus of the neuron, while the white matter is made up of the axons of these nucleus. And why it is white in color? Because the axon is covered by the myelin, which is white in color. Understood, all of you, or not? please give me a quick thumbs up if this is clear. Very, very important, and I guess very, very easy. If you cut the brain like this, you will see the inner part is white and the outer part is gray. The outer part is gray because it consists of the nucleus of the neuron, and the inner part is white because it consists of the axonal part or the fibers which carries the sensation. I hope you know that the direction of carrying the sensation is from nucleus to the axon like this, and there are multiple axons which forms the synapse to form a complete tract. So if you understand this much, I think most of the part you will anyway understand the gray matter and the white matter of the brain. Now if you remember, few days back I've told you something about spinal cord. How many of you remember this? Do you see gray matter and white matter in spinal cord? Yes or no? Do you see the gray matter or white matter in the spinal cord also? Yes or no? Quickly answer this question. The answer is yes, but the arrangement is different. And how the arrangement is different? In spinal cord, the white matter is present on the outer part, but the gray matter is present on the inner part. Look at this. This is the transverse section of the spinal cord. What is this? This is the posterior median fissure, anterior median sulcus. Then this is the whole cut section of the spinal cord. This white area is the white matter, and the central part is the gray matter. So in the spinal cord, the nucleus is present here in the gray matter, and tracts are present in the peripheral part. Okay, so it is in the opposite direction in the spinal cord. Okay, now spinal cord, it consists of how many spinal nerves? You know, anyone, how many spinal nerves? There are total 31 spinal nerves. Now these spinal nerves come out through the spinal cord. The spinal nerve has two components. The posterior component or the dorsal component carries the, what is it? The posterior component carries the sensory fibers, while the anterior component carries the motor fiber. Please remember, the sensation enters from the posterior root of the spinal cord, and the motor action occurs from the anterior root of the spinal cord. Please remember, this is very important. Everything has been asked a lot in your entrance examination. You need to know what is the orientation. I will tell you everything about spinal cord after some time, when we will be discussing about the tracts, like the ascending tracts and the descending tracts. So I will be telling you everything then, but for now just remember that you do see the gray matter and white matter in spinal cord also, but the difference is the sequence is reverse. Okay, chalo, now again we are going to the brain. Yes, so we have discussed that you have an inner white part and you have an outer gray part in your brain. Now coming to this part, there are three type of fibers which are present in the brain, which means that the white matter of the brain is made up of three type of fibers. One is called as association fiber, another is called as commissural fibers, and the third one is called as projection fibers. Now I have found a very, very interesting image here, which will tell you in just few seconds that what are these different type of fibers. What are these different type of fibers? Now look at the first fibers, which is the association fibers. Association fibers are those fibers which connect the different portion of the same lobe. If you remember, I've told you that you have two lobes, the right lobe and the left lobe. So the fibers which connect the part of one area or one lobe from the another part of the same lobe, these are called as association fiber. and they help in association of two different Brodmann areas together. For example, if somebody want to hear, see what is happening in this class, you all are hearing what I'm speaking, and then after listening to me, you are speaking yourself. So this means that there should be a fibers which connect my auditory areas from my motor speech areas. So these fibers which connect the two different areas of same lobe, they are called as association fibers. For example, if you see something coming, automatically you change your direction. So there should be, suppose you are walking on a road and there is a cow or a buffalo running towards you. So what you will do, immediately you will see, you will process and you will turn your direction. So there should be a connection between your visual area and your motor area so that you can do all these math. Please give me a thumbs up if you understood this. So for connecting the two different areas of a same lobe, you have the fibers which is called as association fibers. Everybody give me a quick thumbs up if you understood. This is a very important concept. If you remember this, trust me, whole anatomy becomes very easy. And that is why I'm starting with the toughest topic of anatomy. I could have start from upper limb, I could have start from lower limb, which is very, very easy topic. But neuroanatomy is something very difficult, and I've seen a lot of educators, they even do not teach neuroanatomy. Okay, but I thought of teaching it all together because if you understand the basis, you will understand everything in your anatomy. Chalo, very nice all of you. So please look at this, association fibers, it connects the different areas of the same lobe. Association fibers are of two type, long and short. There are two type of association fibers, long fibers and short fibers. What does short fibers do? They connect the adjacent gyri. I hope you remember we have a lot of gyri, lot of sulci and lot of gyri. So the short fiber connects the two adjacent gyri like this. Understood all of you? I hope there is nothing to explain here that the short fibers conduct the adjacent gyri together. What does the long fiber do? As the name suggests, it will connect the distant part together. You have total four type of long association fibers. One is superior longitudinal fibers or fasciculus, inferior longitudinal fasciculus or fiber, cingulum fiber, and there is uncinate process. And I hope you remember, uncinate process connects your auditory area with your Broca's speech area. The superior longitudinal fasciculus will connect your frontal area with your occipital area. The inferior longitudinal fasciculus will connect your temporal area with your occipital area. So please remember, all these are the example of association fibers which connects the different areas of the same lobe. Clear with this? So we are done with the association fibers, all of you. Coming to the commissural fibers. Now this blue one is a commissural fiber. Can you tell me which two areas is connected by a commissural fiber? Anyone? Riya, Yash, Komal, Raj Kishore, Red Tie. Anyone can tell me which two areas is covered by the commissural fibers? Anyone here? Anyone can tell me this? So please look at this image. This is the right side of the brain. This is the left side or left lobe of the brain. So commissural fibers connect the two different lobes together. So from right lobe and the left lobe, the fibers which extend, these are called as your commissural fibers. Please give me a quick thumbs up if you understood very, very important topic that the commissural fiber connects the same areas of the two different lobes. Now what are the commissural fibers? We have a lot of commissural fibers. We have corpus callosum, which is the thickest and the largest. We have anterior commissural fibers, we have posterior commissural fibers, hippocampal fibers, or habenular commissure. Clear? I think everybody is giving me the answers, so it's clear to all of you. We will discuss corpus callosum little in detail. because it is a frequently asked topic, corpus callosum. Now, this is the section when I look at or when I cut the brain in the sagittal section. For example, like this. If this is my brain and if I cut it like this and I look from the side, this is how you will look on the medial aspect of the brain. This is how you will see the corpus callosum. And what is this view, anyone? What is this view? This is when you cut your brain. Suppose if this is your, I'm very sorry, the image, I hope you are able to understand this image. If I cut my brain like this and if I look it from the top, then this will be the view which I will see. Understood both the views? The first one is the sagittal view, that I'm cutting it like this. And another one is I'm cutting my head like this and I'm looking from the top. Please understand this. These views are very important in your anatomy classes. So if I look it under the sagittal view, I can see four parts of corpus callosum. The anteriormost part is genu, which have a thin extension in the lower part, which is called as rostrum. The upper part or the concave part of the corpus callosum is formed by the trunk, and the posterior part is formed by the splenium. So what are the four parts of the corpus callosum? Rostrum, genu, trunk and splenium. Clear? Now what does it do? Look at this image. This is the corpus callosum. So I am looking at it by a cut section. I hope you are understanding it. So this is the main body of corpus callosum, which is connecting the two lobes together by these fibers. Can you see these fibers? So these fibers which passes through the body of the corpus callosum, can anybody tell me what are these fibers called as? Which are passing through the body, these are called as tapetum. Now there are few fibers which is passing like this. Can you see in the front? From the genu part, can you see few fibers which are passing like, or which is looking like a fork? So this anterior part which is passing through the genu is called as forceps minor. And the fibers which are present in the occipital region which passes through the splenium, this is called as forceps minor. So forceps minor, tapetum and forceps majors, these are the three type of fibers which are passing through the corpus callosum. Please give me a thumbs up if you understood. Please give me, see Abhishek, it is always best to understand and then to learn. If you only mug up the mnemonics also, you will tend to forget the mnemonics in the exams. So try to understand the topic very clearly. There is no need of any mnemonic, there is no need of ratifying. You just understand it and start practicing your exams or start doing the MCQs. Nothing is difficult, trust me. Clear all of you? So Komal, Abhishek, Tina, Yash, I think everybody is clear with the components of the corpus callosum. Now similar to that, you have anterior commissure. Anterior commissure is present just below the rostrum. Can you see here? This is the anterior commissure. I'll use a black color pen. I think that will be better visualized. So just below the rostrum, you have anterior commissure. At the posterior part, at the posterior part, that is just below the splenium, you have the posterior commissure. Just little above the splenium, here, you have habenular commissure. And somewhere around here, just below the corpus callosum, somewhere here, you have hippocampal commissure. Understood all of you? So we have discussed all the commissures, corpus callosum, anterior commissure which is present little below the rostrum, the posterior commissure present little below the splenium, hippocampal which is present below the corpus callosum, and habenular is present little above the posterior commissure. So please remember all these. Riya, what do you want me to repeat? Any confusion, Riya? What exactly you want me to repeat? आई थिंक दैट्स ऑल फॉर द टुडे, अदरवाइज विल नॉट एबल टू टेक अ लॉट. प्लीज गिव मी आपको एक थम्स अप इफ एनीबडी वॉन्ट्स टू डिस्कस एनीथिंग. वी आर स्टॉपिंग द क्लास हियर बिकॉज अदरवाइज इफ आई टेल यू अ लॉट इन वन डे यू आर नॉट एबल टू रिवाइज इट. विल डू स्मॉल स्मॉल टॉपिक्स एवरी डे. श्रुति ओके आई विल टेल यू अबाउट द फाइबर्स अगेन. सो प्लीज रिमेंबर व्हाइट मैटर कंसिस्ट ऑफ थ्री फाइबर्स, असोसिएशन, कमिश्युरल फाइबर्स एंड द प्रोजेक्शन फाइबर्स. We are not discussing the projection fibers today, we'll discuss it tomorrow. Association fibers are those fibers which connect two different areas of the same lobe, while commissural fibers are those which covers the same area of two different lobes. The association fibers are short and long. Short will connect the two adjacent gyri, while long will connect the two different areas. For example, superior longitudinal fiber will connect frontal and occipital. The inferior longitudinal will connect temporal and occipital. Cingulum will connect the cingulate gyrus, and uncinate process will connect the auditory areas with the Broca's area. Now coming to the commissural fibers which connect the same areas of the two different lobe, starting with corpus callosum. Now please remember this is one lobe and this is another lobe, and imagine this to be the commissural fiber, so it is connecting like this. I hope this is clear. So this is the connecting fiber and these are the two lobe. Now I am looking it from the top. Just imagine that I am looking it from the top. So there are multiple fibers which are connecting each other. You are looking it from the top like this. I am looking it from the top. So in the center, few fibers are connecting like this straight. These are called as tapetum fibers. Few fibers are in a fork-like manner present on the anterior part, which is called as forceps minor, and few fibers are present in a forceps minor on the behind, which is called as forceps major. Understood this point? Shruti, Riya, everyone give me a thumbs up if you understood. I am looking, if this is the connecting fibers or the commissural fibers, I am looking it from the top like this. Please give me a quick thumbs up everyone if you understood till here. ठीक है. सो आई थिंक वी शुड नॉट रीड मोर देन दिस, अदरवाइज एवरीथिंग विल गो अबव योर हेड. वी शुड एंड आवर क्लास टुडे हियर इटसेल्फ. आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू अनअकैडमी. यू विल गेट द पीडीएफ्स ऑफ ऑल दीज क्लासेस ऑन द अनअकैडमी लर्निंग ऐप. यू जस्ट नीड टू यूज द रेफरल कोड डॉक्टर चेष्टा वाईटी फॉर सब्सक्रिप्शन. एंड इफ यू आर इन योर फर्स्ट ईयर और सेकेंड ईयर ऑफ MBBS, please go for iconic subscription using the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT. So please use the code Dr. Cheshta YT and get all these notes and PDFs, as well as get my plus courses also. Please subscribe to an academy using the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT. Okay, Dr. Cheshta is my name and YT is the YouTube. Do biochem also in future, it will be helpful. Definitely red tie. There are many students who are behind me for biochemistry also. So I think biochemistry is something which many of you are not able to understand. Chalo, anyways, first we'll focus on anatomy, which is itself a very, very broad topic. But don't worry, if time permits, we'll definitely cover the other subjects as well. In the end, please do not forget my dermatology sessions also. I take a lot of dermatology classes. Do my